In this video, I'm going to show you how to create an HDR image in Photomatix Pro from photos taken under multiple exposures. You can also use Photomatix with a single photo, in which case, you can skip the merge steps that I'll show you next. The first photo is taken at the normal exposure and shows the details in the midtones. This is not sufficient to show well the details in both the sky and the shadows. The second photo is underexposed and shows the details in the sky well. The third photo is overexposed and shows the details in the shadows well. To load the photos, select the files in the Finder and drag them to the Photomatix icon on your dock. You will then get a dialog asking you what you would like to do with these files. Select Merge for HDR Tone Mapping and Fusion, and click on OK. Click on OK to go to the next step. The next window lets you specify options for merging the photos. Check the Align Source Images option. This option corrects for misalignment problems when the camera moves slightly between the bracketed frames, which will happen if you took the photos handheld. But checking this option is recommended even if you used a tripod. If your scene includes moving objects or people, check the Show Options to Remove Ghosts box. If the files you loaded were RAW files, check the Reduce Noise option. You may also check this option with JPEG files if needed. Click on Align and Merge to HDR. The preview in the middle shows a preview of the final tone mapped image. You can adjust the preview size using the magnifier icons on top. The presets panel on the right lets you select a style for your image. You can display the thumbnails in two columns or at a larger size by clicking on the icons on the top right of the presets panel. The built-in presets show by default. If you have saved custom presets, click on the My Preset tab to view their thumbnails. You can filter the preset display to show only those of the type you are interested in by selecting a category name from the pop-up menu item on the top of the panel. Try different presets to choose a style you like from the thumbnails listed. Clicking on a thumbnail shows the effect of the preset on the preview window. Balanced. Photographic. Natural. Soft. Monochrome. Painterly. Painterly 4. Painterly 5. Vibrant. Surreal. Surreal 2. Grunge. Creative. Once you have found a preset you like, you can refine the effect by adjusting the controls on the settings window on the left. With the buttons at the bottom of the window, you can undo or redo settings and restore the default settings for the current method. Once you're satisfied with the adjustments, click on the Apply button so that you can then save the image. Before saving, you can add a finishing touch to your image. The Finishing Touch panel lets you increase the contrast of your image, sharpen it, or adjust the saturation of individual colors. The final image is 16 bits per color channel. When you save the image, you can choose to save it as 8-bit JPEG if desired. You can see several examples of tone-mapped images in the user gallery at the HDRsoft website. Download a free trial of Photomatix Pro 5 today at hdrsoft.com and see what it can do for your photos.